Welcome back. You look fantastic. We have a lot to get to. A lot of questions for you. First off, what's it like? You're a grandparent now since the last time you've been on our show. Do you have three grandkids?
Well, first of all, it's great to see you again.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Let's get a little bit personal here.
I jumped right into the thing.
Last time I saw you was we were smoking a cigar in a Havana room.
Do you remember that?
Yeah, absolutely.
With Drew Barrymore.
How to smoke a cigar.
Well, I didn't know how to smoke.
You started lighting the wrong end. He started cutting off the wrong end. Everything was off. And I said, oh, my God, I hope we never do your show like that.
No, but I said to you, because I didn't know what to do, and I started licking it.
You don't lick a cigar. This other thing.
No, but I heard that someone told me to do that to keep it moist or something. You're like, no, you do not lick the cigar. You don't lick the cigar. They're yelling at me. And you were very nice to me, and you were very patient with me. Yeah.
Thank you. But anyway, to answer your question, I have two grandchildren. Lila and Eloise.
Oh, my.
And they're fantastic. I mean, they're coming over to the house all the time.
What do they call you?
Opa.
Opa.
Yeah, because it's a German word, right?
Yeah.
For grandpa.
Yeah.
It's Opa. And Catherine and Chris, her husband, they come over to the house at least, I think, once a week. And then I play with the animals with them. You know, it's just we have a great time. I put them on the back of the miniature donkey.
You have so many great animals.
I know. And then one wanted to ride the pig. I said, no, the pigs, you don't ride pigs.
But it's anyway, a lovable pig,
So they play around with the animals. We have really a great, great time. The only thing is that they are a little spoiled.
Yeah.
Because when I took them to the stall and I asked them to help me, you know, shovel the manure, they said no.
You got to teach them.
Chris right away said, no. They are not brought up to do that.
No, they don't do that. That really, I was telling you, I love the documentary about you because I just think you know enough about you. But when I watch that, I go, oh, my gosh, this is so cool. You have, like, a farm. And how many animals do you have? Do you know?
Well, I have three dogs, Cherry, I call her Noodle, which is a little one. She's 15 years old. Then I have Dutch, which is a Malamute. Yeah. And then I have Schnitzel, which is a wonderful female, a big, big monster dog. And then I have the miniature, horses, miniature pony, Lulu, and Whiskey, which is a miniature, pony. And it was just fantastic, those animals. And the pig, which is a new addition, which we have had the pig now for almost a year. And that pig is really fun.
Yeah.
And he loves to eat. and it took a while for them to get along. You know, because, you know, the pig is not used to the dogs.
He's a new member of the family.
We're not used to the pig and all of that stuff. So it took a while. But they all come into the kitchen, and I feed them every day, every morning. This is my routine. I get up at 5:30 in the morning.
And then
for 1 hour, I feed the animals.
That's what you do in the documentary. You go for every morning, you wake up, that's your job,
absolutely.
And you bring them in the kitchen, make them breakfast.
In the kitchen, well, not breakfast, but I mean, we have this oatmeal cookies. Oatmeal cookies, yes, that we put together that are made out of honey and out of bananas and oatmeal.
They're living their best lives.
Oh, I'm telling you. So they were made for the horses, basically, for Lulu and for Whiskey. But I realized that the dogs also love them. Love the cookies. And then I found out that the pig loves the cookies. But the pig loves everything.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah,
pig will eat stones, you know.
There's no difference.
But anyway, so all of them love it. And so when Catherine comes over with my grandchildren, I mean, they then stand in line and so then I give a cookie, you know, to Lulu, then I give a cookie to Dutch, I give a cookie to Schnitzel, a cookie to Schnelli, the pig, and then the two girls stand there like this. Just like the animals. And then I put a little, like I separate it.
Yeah.
They give one little cookie her mouth, and one little cookie in her mouth, then they eat the cookies. So as soon as we go outside, she says right there, Opa, can I have more cookies?
Yeah.
You know, they love the cookies and everything like that. So they really enjoy coming over to the house.
I think
and having
you should
fun
do
with the animals.
A kid's book. That's the next book for you. It's called, like, One Little Cookie or something. Yeah, or everyone have a cookie and have all the farm animals
on
there.
Can you be my co-writer?
Yes, done. Okay, done. I'll do it in 2 seconds. I can't smoke a cigar if I can write a book.
Get some humor into the whole thing.
Yes.
Yeah, exactly.
I got your newest book here. This is a great book called Be Useful. And you guys, you should pick this up. It is so great, by the way. It's so just tips on living life, and living a long life.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's like it's 7 tools to life for life, and it is basically the things that I wanted to share with the people of how you can become more successful and happier with your life, how you can accomplish your goals and all of those things. Because there's so many people that need help, and this came out of actually a speech that I did, a commencement speech at the university, and I gave the students the tools to success.
Yeah.
And it was such a huge hit. Then another university invited me, and another one. So I was doing all these commencement speeches, giving them the tools to success. And the next thing I know is that people ask me to do a book. And so I did the book, and then, of course, I did an app, the Pump Club.
Oh, the Pump app is, by the way, that's great, too.
Yeah, exactly,
I mean,
yeah.
I'm like a
and
super
fan. And it's all about positiveness, you know? It's kind of like there's so many negative stuff when you go online now, and this is kind of a positive corner where people kind of learn about how to help themselves. And, we have this newsletter, and it is just huge. It's gigantic. We have almost a million people now that are part of that.
And being positive on the internet is a rare thing.
And it's not just that I give them advice, that now it is a community where they give each other advice and they pump each other up and they build each other up. So this is what it's all about, is helping people to become more successful, to be happier. That's what it's all about. So, this is my...
I love that. Yeah, be useful. And get the Pump app. Hey, hey.